Let me pull this, and you're probably just wondering why the hell I'm wearing this. All of you, I can see your faces are just like, oh my gosh, is that her? And yes, this is actually how it would look like if I was back in my country. But the things that you can associate this appearance with, like the stereotypes, the images, and the ideas that come to mind when you first see a person like this. If you did not know me before, you would probably think I'm quite narrow-minded, I'm quite primitive, I do not know any other languages, I cannot tolerate people, I'm quite ignorant, and probably just came from a desert on a camel. Probably that way. But this couldn't be further from the truth. Because geographically, all Arabs and the stereotypical of Arabs and Muslims is on such a huge scale that it's geographically impossible for it to be real. Because you cannot compare the west of Asia and the west of Africa and expect them to be the same. This is impossible because in one country you have many differences, many different accents, many different traditional clothes, many different values and what's important and what's not important. So just the assumption that Arabs or Muslims or even Syrians are all the same, this could not be more wrong. So I will just change my appearance a little bit so you guys can relate to me more.
Okay. I even watched some tutorials on how to like put it on. It's quite complicated.
It's quite easy.
No, but like the full ones.
The full one, the, yeah. Okay, so I guess now you can relate to me more because this is something that you're more accustomed to. And you can listen to me more now, yeah? Because yeah, I'm normal. So I just need to stress the stereotypes that associate themselves, attach to themselves to certain groups of people are very, they're very frustrating because when you first go to another country and you live in a foreign country, all of the questions that were first asked were just ridiculous, and I wouldn't even consider asking them to anybody, no matter how far they came from. Like questions as in, do you seriously do this? Or what's that thing that you wear? Do you seriously have to do this? And do your parents force you to do that? And it's just completely unnecessary and very not important. Because like here, when it's extremely cold, which is like half of the year, I'm freezing right now. Here you have to wear like a lot of clothes and you cover your heads with beanies or hats or I don't know what, hoodies. And it's completely fine and normal and acceptable. It's something that you're all accustomed to. But if it's the idea of just covering your hair for like with a hijab, just as a part of tradition, more than a cult, more than a religion, that seems so absurd and so weird and unrealistic and just like very far and alien like. So I just don't understand why beanies and I don't know, hats are fine, but a hijab is not. And you guys don't even know what the name of it is. Like, it has many names, but most of people just ask about, does it really exist? And without even knowing what it's called. So yeah, that's just something I needed to get out of the way. So I say once and for all, and I'm not gonna repeat myself again. That's it. Yeah. And when you first meet a person that's a foreigner, you ask them where they come from, and so you can understand more of their background and to which group they belong to. Now, if you ask me that, I'll tell you I'm Syrian, I'm Arabic, and I'm a Muslim, and all of those things. And you would put me in the same category as the idea of like refugees in Europe is like such a conflict in these days. And just I can separate myself from them and I can tell you I'm not them because I'm not a refugee. I live here legally. I live here legally and I go to school and I pay for everything and I am just doing everything that you guys do. And I can say I'm not in the same group as them, even though I have the same nationality, even though I'm from the same neighborhood even. But then that wouldn't true because I am them. I just had more opportunities. If they had the same chances, they would have done like me and even more. So I can separate myself from them, and you can separate yourself from us too. You can say you're all European, and you can say you're all from different languages, different religions, and you're just like completely different. But then, we're all in the same planet, and we're all very similar, and you have no idea how our cultures are connected. Because in Syria, when we were ruled by other countries for more than 400 years, I think, well, we had a lot of problems of conserving our own traditions and cultures. And in Poland, here, you have that too. Because for more than 100 years, Poland was not even on the map. And now I'm learning Polish, and I see how well kept the language is, and I really value that. It's very touching that such a thing can be reserved so well. Because just the idea of your identities and your values and your language being so well kept and so perfect as they were, with no changes whatsoever, no matter if people would say that Poland didn't even exist, that it wasn't there, so the Polish identity isn't valuable. That's not true, because it's so well saved. So that's the thing that our countries also share, because till now, my father uses words that I don't understand, because they come from like Phoenician times, like old times, and I have no idea how he got them. And sometimes I'm just like, okay, Dad, speak Arabic, please, because I don't get what you're saying. Yeah, and so these things also show how similar we are and how not different we are. Like, okay, I can be more tan, I have, I don't know, bigger eyes, I'm not blonde, but that doesn't mean I'm completely different. I do love, I do feel, and I have values, I have traditions, and I am open-minded to other people, because I need them to be open-minded to me. Because I can't expect, when it comes to racism as well, I can't expect a country to be so well-kept and not for me to expect to have a little bit of closed-mindedness. Because, okay, racism is bad, it's not good, but then if a person values his own traditions and cultures and his own ideas, and defends them with all of his being, because that's how you actually got here, then I would understand. I'm very, like, I don't mind when people are racist, because I know where they come from. Now I understand. So even when somebody acts in a racist way, before I used to just put them as like, okay, they're racist, they're bad people, I'm not gonna even listen to their ideas and their stories. But now I get what they're coming from. I know how difficult it can be, and how it's difficult to differentiate between different sides and different people and different situations. So I get it. And I myself was before very narrow-minded. I was homophobic, and I was extremely, extremely religious. Believe me, I was. I used to be completely all about religion and praying, and oh my gosh, I should not even listen to music. So like some. For a certain period of time, I did not even listen to music. I was just like completely detached from my own self. I did not agree on anything anybody would tell me, and I would just listen to my friends, because they influenced me a lot. And that's like, okay. Yeah, so I was like that, and at some point I was just like, okay, maybe get back to music, because like, you lost yourself a bit there, Boushra, so you should probably get that contract, and then I went back again to being myself, because at that time I was not. Because it's not because of religion, and it's not because of being very strict about anything, but I just needed to go to the extreme to completely know what the story is and to completely be able to control it. Because if I did not know, then I wouldn't know how to control it either. So I went through that, and it was like a really tough time, because I had a lot of troubles in my relationships with my friends, with my family, with myself even. I had a lot of troubles with myself. And yeah, so I went back again to being me, and then I realized how much of a mistake I made. But I don't regret it, because now I'm standing in front of you, and I'm talking about this, and you can know how it can be to be very narrow-minded, and it's very very limiting. I could not do what I wanted to do, and I could not say what I wanted to say, just because I did not believe in me, and I categorized myself in one group. So, Boushra, you're a Muslim, you have to do this, and that's all. So my last goal back then was just like to go to heaven and to, I don't know, succeed in the afterlife, which is actually quite important. And I'm not gonna go into the religious part because that's like a completely different thing. But that was not all, that's not everything. I am living now, so I should be using my time wisely. So okay, I will work for the afterlife, but at the same time, I'm gonna be who I am without losing my identity. And especially, I had to ask myself a lot of questions after all of the advices I took from my friends about how religion is and how God is and how everything should be. Before, I did not ask myself, where they're coming from or are they really true? But now I just overanalyze them because I'm extremely careful now because I know how bad it can get. And so all of this goes down to wanting to be somewhere, to say that this is my identity, this is who I am, and this is where I actually belong. It can be your country, it can be your house, it can be your group of friends, it can be your religion, it can be anything. But you need to like touch it and see it most of the time, so you can like have a living proof of this. But after a while of like experiencing a lot of moving from my own experiences, I moved to, okay, so I'm gonna make this real quickly. I was born in Syria, I moved to Lebanon, I went to Qatar Doha in the Gulf area, I went back to Syria, and then back to Qatar, and then now I'm here in Poland. So let's just say I had a fair amount of moving in my life, and I'm only 17, for God's sake. Just only 17, I did all that, it's like too much already. Yeah, but after a while of moving and not having everything that's constant, at least one constant, I can't say I've been in a school for more than 4 years in a row. This is like the furthest I could go. I could not do any more in a house, even from one school to another, I would move. From one house to another, I would move. And friends and all of the people around you always change. But so I could not use them as my home and my true identity. So after a while, when I was growing up, I did not think about it too much because all I cared about was fitting into school, getting my education right, and that's it basically. Having one friend or two, it's all right as long as they can tolerate me, I can tolerate them. But after when growing up, you ask yourself this question: where do I actually belong? Who am I? What am I doing in my life? What's my purpose? All of these questions sometimes can be quite stressful and sometimes can be quite relieving because you would be just like sitting there and suddenly realization would hit you and you just say, oh my gosh, this is home, this is where I belong to, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. But other times, these questions are, they're so dynamic. Sometimes they're really, really negative, they get really negative and they can get you in like the worst of situations, and that happens with me quite a lot. Especially when I last moved to Poland. And not because it's Poland, it's a bad country, no. It's just the idea of moving to a different school, from a completely different culture to another, and with different languages, even the weather was bad to me, because it's too damn cold. I miss my son, come on. Yeah, so after all of that, I needed a basis to keep me on my feet, because I did not have all of the physical elements, all the people that will just give me the sense of being where I should be. So I came to the conclusion that as long as I know that there is the sea out there somewhere, and that there is the moon that I can see in parts of the month, and that me is still me, and I know I'm true to myself, and I'm true to the feeling that I have inside, and I'm not being fake to myself, even more before being fake towards other people. As long as all of these things, I have them, and they're all right, then I am at home, because I am home. Wherever I am, I will be home, because I know what I want to do, I know what feels right, what doesn't feel right, I know my values, and what's important to me. Thank you very much.